Hello, RPG Chick here with another episode of Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. We have to kill the Skuldr King and his stinky little Skuldr whelps. I don't know if we should take out the whelps first or make them like the victims of collateral damage. There's the whelp. Yeah, I'm gonna start up pretty much identical. So we start wailing on his son. Throw some arrows. And he's gonna run along and pretty much we have to hit him. I'll try to get them with Fan of Flames. Of course, I'm going to focus on the king. Like the king, baby.
Eh?
Oh, we killed him outright. Awesome. That's what I'm talking about. Alright, so magic missiles on that guy. I don't think they can miss. Well, mind wave's not going to be effective yet. Actually, I'm just going to wait for them to get closer. Of course, just gonna run up and hit him. Actually, well, let's leave her here. I want to use Fan of Flames. Let's just have her stay here.
Eh?
Oh my god! Is she... She's down already? Oh my god. That's it. Oh my god. We're dead.
Yes.
And he didn't even cast his spell yet.
How may I help?
Thick.
Interrupted. Oh yeah. Might as well kill her. Right. Are we supposed to come back here and fight these because they're way too hard? Wait, is this the wrong... Didn't I save my game after that? No, I didn't. Okay, I'll be right back, guys. Okay, I'm gonna try this again. I don't know if I can, by rights, kill these things. No, I'm not... Actually, we can kill these easily. Stop saying things. It's this thing. So, yeah, pretty bad. So what do you think? She's already using that. He can hit with that. Now, is this really good? Is this a good spell? 37 to 48 corrode. Corrode damage over 6.5 seconds. Okay. I assume these things can corrode. Oh, I thought I switched her over. All right.
Care of it.
Okay, he's still casting a spell. Mind blades. Oh my god. Is she down? She got knocked down or something. Did she ever cast it? She never casted a spell. You need to do that now. Oh, he's down. It's actually down to two. I think I have to come back here with more adventurers. Thing he can't get around his own kids. Now he's moving this way, so let's do it like that. She kicks butt, I'll tell you that much. She's still... Yeah, she's done. She's done with it. Okay. Yep. Alright, we need to come back here another time. We have more people or more powerful people. I think we need to go up at least two more levels before we do that. Let's,
No problem.
Oh wait, no, nope, these are the wrong stairs I'm thinking about. Let me head back and I'll see you guys on the flip side. It is, his name is Wirtan.
God's keep you.
Wirtan smiles nervously as you approach. Think I've sorted out the worst of it. Arm's hurting a little less. He hesitates. You were down there a while. Did you find anything? His eyes dart constantly about the ruins. We weren't there now that long. You saw us run back and forth to get more camping supplies constantly. Did he lie to us? Yeah, they were torturers. They were locked in there, I guess. He either lied or he didn't know about it. Kind of like that, though. Something you're nervous about? No, of course not. Just never good to linger around these places, that's all. Wirtan gives you a searching look. Did you find anything? I did. Here they are, as you asked for. The color drains from Wirtan's face. He takes the bundle from you with trembling hands. You found them, then? He stares down at the bones. I found more than bones. Something valuable, you mean? You can keep whatever you found. I don't want any of it. Nobody's been down below since... Yeah, so now his name is Wirtan, we know, so... Yeah, he was the one responsible. Nobody's been down there below since... Radric's people have no interest in Eothasian goods, is my point. They won't miss whatever you take. Ooh, perception 12 we can do. You're very nervous for an honest man. Something weighing on your conscience, maybe? Wirtan opens his mouth to protest, but something in your expression stops him. He swallows nervously and looks away. His voice, when he speaks, is small. How could you betray them? They trusted you. Wirtan makes a strange, wounded noise. Betrayed? I was never one of them. Mad followers of the Shattered God. If I could have chased them all out of town, You don't understand. I tried to help them. I did. Every day. Every single day I went to that temple, and I warned them. I told them that they were playing with fire, and Radric wouldn't be patient forever. And every time they'd shrug it off, like I didn't know what I was talking about, like it wasn't costing me coming in to try and help them, I could have been arrested right alongside them. We can pick the Intellect 13. You worked for Radric. I prefer to have him explain rather than us feed him answers. What happened? Radric sent word he was going to have them arrested. Track them out. Lock them up. They wouldn't listen. The Retrix said they'd be reborn if anything should happen, and she wasn't afraid. Yeah, reborn into twisted shadows. I convinced them to hide, at least. They have that vault full of old relics, gold and such. I thought they could hide in there, and once the guards left, they'd have something to sell for passage out of the Deerwood, back to Adir. But when I told the man that the priests had already gone, they ordered the temple sealed. I couldn't get in again. Wirtan shakes his head. There was nothing I could do. You could have spoken up. Told Radric the truth. Wirtan nods slowly. I could have. It would have ruined me. Maybe killed me. But I could have saved them. He looks up at you, eyes wet. I didn't. We know that. I told you the way of it, Wirtan says, his voice rough. I told you what happened. Guess it's your turn now to make a decision. I guess this Eothas option is if you're a paladin or a priest following Eothas. It's not too late to make amends. Wirtan lets out the breath he was holding. I'm not sure that's true. It's been years now. What am I supposed to do? Shrug. I'm not great at the redemption business, personally. Wirtan looks at the remains. He runs a hand through his hair, letting out another ragged breath. Suppose I'll have to figure it out. I can bury them, at least. Like I said I do. As long as we get our money. Thank you, truly, for what you've done. Give me a second chance. I'll put it to good use. Hey. Gods forgive me. Did he give us money? He can give us any money. 1053 experience. We can't even level up with this experience. Oh, I should have demanded money. Next time. We're done in there until we get strong enough to fight that king, that Skuldr King. This temple used to be closed up. I used to climb on the big stones. Papa says the temple is cursed.
Yeah.
Papa's right. Now this guy, there's an important guy over here. He's actually marked on the map. So... he's right there. There's something about that guy, because... talk to this. Oh, look!
I have received confirmation that Lord Radric's heir was not born well. My lord has issued an injunction on all new homesteads until he can be assured that the village has been cleansed of all Aothasians and whatever other undesirables that have brought this curse upon his lands.
Huh.
It would be best if you left town as soon as possible. I would suggest returning to your old home. There will be no place for you here. You may stay at the inn until you can make the necessary arrangements, but I would not advise remaining long. I expect Lord Radric will be most thorough in his efforts to purify this place.
This is outrageous. I came a long way. Then you should have no problem continuing on. Trust me when I say it would be best if you were not here when Lord Radric's men are dispatched from his hold. They will be looking for anyone who might have brought the legacy upon us, whose very presence might have polluted his wife's womb. They will extinguish all possibilities. Yeah, whatever, I gotta go talk to this corpse. Caldara di Baranzi. The squat, distended body of an elderly dwarf woman dangles from a thin, crooked bough that sags at the tug of her noose. The bloated purple flesh of her neck, worn away in patches like moth-eaten linen, bulges over the rope that suspends her, and her lifeless head lolls forward rigidly from one side to the other when the breeze shifts. You perceive a faint glow around her that casts no light on its surroundings, but there is a tepid warmth to it, and you feel somehow that you could reach out and touch it, not with your hands, but with some aspect of yourself that has no worldly dimension. Yeah, let's reach out with the aspect with the no worldly dimension. You take a deep breath, clearing your mind, focusing on your objective. As you exhale, you feel yourself spreading out toward the hanging woman, perceiving all that lies between you and her with new, unfamiliar awareness. Once you have expanded enough to reach her, there is a sudden jolt to your mind, a ringing electric surge of images and words and sounds. Involuntarily, you shut your eyes and feel yourself being pulled down to some deeper consciousness in a space occupied only by you and the hanging woman, and when you open them again, she is staring at you with eyes clouded in a milky fog, her body still swaying in a wind you no longer feel from a tree that stands planted in a misty void. The woman gives a slow nod of her neck, the rope creaking as she does so, and she smiles at you.
Have you come here for me, dear, or have you gotten lost? Ah, it is both, I think. Yes?
Her eyes squint as she peers down at you. How are you able to speak to me?
Is that what we're doing? Perhaps it just seems that way. Perhaps it is the easiest way for your mind to make sense of it. I think it is a very good choice.
I want to know something about you.
Me? I'll bore you to tears, though.
She shakes her head in protest. Who are you?
And here I thought you'd come to visit me in particular. Caldara de Baranzi, of the Valian Royal Academy of Animantic Sciences. Not the greatest of their number, But I came here all the same because this was where help was needed.
She breathes a mild sigh, sending a small beetle skittering from inside her cheek. Her arms turn outward stiffly in what might be a curtsy. What happened to you? She laughs, a rasp, choking cackle escaping between rows of buttery yellow teeth, causing her body to bob up and down with each spasm. Seeing your blank expression, she catches herself.
Oh, come now, such a question, as though the answer were plain as a rope tied for strangling. Allow an old dwarf her last bit of cheer. Well, I came where I was needed, didn't I? Offered my services to Lord Radric for a pittance, a humble pittance. I was to examine the Lord's wife, see why the gods have seen fit to poison her womb. Studied her for months, looked high and low for impurities, tested her valence, the permeability of her essence. Do you know what I found?
Let me guess, she found nothing. And then when the baby was born, without the soul or whatever the hell, they blamed her because she told them nothing was wrong. But go ahead, tell me.
Nothing at all.
Yep.
A healthy woman, head to toe, blessed with a beautiful soul. Such a sweet woman, too. Meek, but warm-hearted. A few months' time, and the lord of the house demanded answers. For a time, I told him what he wanted to hear. Oh, yes, my lord. She is riddled with imbalances. I must have time to cure her. As the birth drew near, he grew impatient, as lords do. And this is where I've ended up.
Oh. So I was right about there's nothing wrong, but... Excuse me, what's an animancer?
A student of the soul. Something so basic, yet so poorly understood. But so many breakthroughs have been made in my lifetime. Had been. To hear the locals tell it, we're a gang of soul manglers that preys upon the weak-minded. And the worst of us are. But the best of us, the best, inspirations, miracle workers. My parents were soul twins, miserable before they met, empty inside. It was an animancer who helped one find the other, turn their lives around. You wouldn't believe the stories. Amnesiacs helped to remember their lives. The suicidal brought back from the brink of oblivion. The elderly afforded extra moments to say their goodbyes. How soon we forget when we're afraid. It's a fascinating science. A fascinating time to be alive in a place like Deerwood that does not control the research, no? I love the Valian Republics for many things, but their recent caution will leave them behind, I fear.
I had other questions.
Of course, dear.
I need to understand something that's happened to me. She nods, a look of pity on her face, as though consoling a child.
The world looks a little different than it used to, is that it? Feels like you're noticing things for the first time that have always been there.
She nods.
You have seen past the shroud. It only takes an instant. Your soul remembers, yes? Remembers how it sees when it leaves the body, like being reminded of a dream you had forgotten.
She nods again.
You are a watcher now, and a watcher you will stay.
Really? So there's no cure for this. What's a watcher?
What indeed? Long hours have many animancers spent studying such things. Not I. I'll tell you what I know, though, since fair is fair. And here we are, visiting, you and I, and it reminds me of better times. Souls pass on, some say through Audra stones, which are the blood veins of the world. They leave the world for a time and are reborn into it, sometimes more than they were before, but usually less and seldom the same. For all souls, there is a time where they do not live, yet have not passed on. And those souls roam the world, same as you or I, either living or lost. But no one sees them because they have forgotten how.
I'm wondering what the emphasis on lost, or capital L.
A watcher sees, though, knows what to look for. And sometimes they know a person just by looking at them. Know where they've been in ages past when their bodies were other bodies.
Bing.
See memories even their honor can't recall. A wonder to behold when all goes well. A wonder!
What did you mean, when all goes well?
Oh, nothing to be afraid of, I'm sure. It's just much to take in for some. Sometimes there's trouble sleeping or other difficulties.
She smiles at you reassuringly, fanning out a tuft of long whiskers that sprouts from one of her cheeks.
You should see old Meerwald. He could tell you much more than I. A watcher just like you, helped many in his day. Took up in an old keep no one would claim. Not far, not far. Kadnua, beyond the Black Meadow. He will welcome the company.
I think I survived a Beowick. Do you know why that would be?
Did you now, dear? My, that would be something, wouldn't it? Could be luck, could certainly be. A storm can be a careless thing. Or maybe it got its hands around your soul but couldn't pick it up. A soul can be heavy if it stayed in one piece through its time. Strong souls, we call them in the trade. Called, I mean. Called them. Those days are all behind me, no?
You said souls break apart over time?
Oh, yes. Entropy. Rimagan's work. We know little of why or how. We lose pieces of ourselves when we die and pick up pieces of others when we are born again. But less than what we lost. We try to stop it with the animantic sciences, but with little success.
Really? So what eventually happens to us?
A very small few resist Rimargan's influence and stay together through some force of defiance, at least for a time. But they all succumb eventually, I think.
She clicks her tongue. I guess the voice actor couldn't do that. Sorry for breaking the fourth wall. Am I imagining this, finally?
No, I think not. A pity that. It would be simpler. A mercy, even. To not have to wander anymore, no? Alas, we are here, you and I. Wherever here may be.
Farewell.
Goodbye, my dear. It was lovely visiting.
Caldera closes her eyes and her head slumps forward over the noose, and your surroundings seem to bleed into your vision from some unknown place of waiting. Wow. And we got more experience. Ooh. And our fighter can level up. Which is great news. Maybe she'll stop dying constantly. So pick one in stealth, athletics. Survival. I have 1 point left. Mechanics. Now I can take bonus knockdown. Against a fighter, an additional use of knockdown per encounter. I haven't even used it yet, I keep forgetting. I don't even know if I can knock down oozes and shadows. Rapid recovery. The amount of time that a character spends between actions. Longer actions result in proportionally longer recovery. Armor has a large effect on recovery. Heavier armor inflicts longer recovery penalties. So she can hit more often. Yeah, let's take that. Ta-da! Firebrand, level 2 fighter, you evil thing. Whoop.
Yeah.
Okay. We gotta figure out what we're doing next here. I think we're done with this place. We do have to go back and buy some more camp supplies. And we're gonna sell a bunch of the stuff that we found. I'll do that off screen. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.